Formula E Marrakesh was always going to be the racetrack rather than an overt street track as we faced in Hong Kong, so we always anticipated it being a hard weekend due to our inability to test as a private team. What transpired though was a really good team and driver effort in the race to bounce back and maximize the points. This ensured we left Africa with Techita still right in the mix, keeping our third place in the championship. Just before we arrived in Marrakesh, the news came through about the fantastic deal between Formula E and the ABB Group. This was a really progressive announcement for the championship, and I think Alejandro Agag and his team should be congratulated on what is a significant partnership with lots of opportunity for technical development in future years. On the racing side of things, there seemed to be something quirky about the cool temperatures in qualifying that affected things, as the first group was pretty much the quickest overall. In our group, the clouds came over the track, and with these Michelin tires it is really tricky, as the grip does get affected. Qualifying is so important in Formula E, and actually is one of the things that make it really special and interesting. It is definitely one of the hardest things to get absolutely right. Jean-Eric made a small mistake in qualifying, and as we have seen, you get punished by getting shuffled down the grid quickly. Even without the slight error, we think we would have been into the top 10, but perhaps not at the front this time. It was just one of those weekends when the lack of testing caught up and hurt us. Andre's qualifying was also difficult, and ultimately he got moved down the grid after getting a penalty for missing a weighbridge call, which was unfortunate for him. The race was really interesting and strong for us on all levels. Jean-Eric made some stellar progress through the field during a really strong race where he made up 8 places and grabbed 10 valuable points for his title campaign. Eb really got his elbows out and attacked, which is pretty much his default setting. The guy is fantastic in a fighting situation, and you can always rely on him to make the most of any racing scenario. It was a joy to watch. To come through from 13th on the grid like that was a really impressive feat on this track, which plainly did not suit us well. Sadly for Andre, his race was compromised with a hardware malfunction. We still have to identify the specifics of it, but it was tough for him because he also made some great progress in the early phase of the race and would have grabbed his first points, I'm sure. Overall though, we came away with Jean-Eric third in the points and the team in the same position in the team's standings. Of course, we want to fight right at the front, and we know that in coming races with some hard work we can achieve much more, but championships are all about maximizing points in the end. Photo: Formula E on Sunday. We had a rare and very welcome opportunity to do some testing in the rookie test, and we chose James Rossiter and Frederick Makovyeki because of their prior experience of the car and good reputation as testing drivers. As the championship's only private team, Techita has just 3 test days, meaning that we had to deliver above and beyond in the test schedule to really make the most out of the opportunity. James and Fred helped us achieve exactly what we wanted, and we now head into Santiago next month. We increased confidence that we have opened up a number of performance areas on the cars. Discover Techita's remarkable video highlighting the impact of climate change on endangered species.